Hello, good afternoon to all of you. Today is a special day for us. Happy Teachers Day to all. And in our previous Teachers Day, we were greatly celebrate this day and miss those day. Today is the special day for you and me. Okay, today we are discuss about life history of Adiantum. Previous lecture, we were already discuss about morphology and anatomy of Adiantum. Today let's we start reproduction of Adiantum. Today first we discuss about sporangia of Adiantum. Sporangia also known as the sori. Sori means sporangia, and sporangia means sori, and sporangia means which part they develop a spore, and sporangia is present on the surface of the leaf. Adiantum leaf in present sporangia, and this sporangia is develop spore. And this leaf is known as the sporophyll, means Adiantum leaf have a capability to develop a spore, and this spore bearing organs is known as sporangia, and this spore bearing leaf is known as the sporophyll. You can see this is the sporophyll and this is the sporangia. And let's we start sporangia bearing organs. Spore bearing organs in the Adiantum reproductive take place mainly by the spore, which are produced in a large number within sporangia. In Adiantum reproduction take place by mainly spore, which is produce a large number within the sporangia. The sporangia from sori close to margin on the dorsal side of the mature pinna, and the leaves bearing sporangia or sori are known as the sporophyll. Sporangia is present dorsal surface. You can see this is the leaflet of the sporangia, and this part is a all sporangia is the present. You can see this figure is the microscopic view of this notch like structure. You can see this is the notch like structure, and their maximized figure is this, and in this notch like structure sporangia is not present. It is known as the false indusium, but in this figure sporangia is this present, and sometimes their notch is the young, and in this notch sometimes sporangia is not present. There are the only the notch like structure is the present, and this part is known as the false indusiums. But in sometimes sporangia is present, and this sporangia is the fertile sporangia. So this is known as the sporangia and sori, and this structure is known. This is the sporangia and sori. You can see these all are the sporangia, and they have capability to develop a spore. Okay, then sori is the present along the both side. There are the spelling mistake. Both side, BOTH, both side of the vein. The sori are present on both side of the vein. You can see in this figure there are the vein, and vein is the both side present, and this sporangia is present both side of the vein. On dorsal side of the margin reflect lobe, and this part remain folded toward the lower side and act as a false indusium, means the lower portion their lower portion is only act as a lobed like structure, and so that is the known as false indusium, and which membranous brown in color, which membranous and brown in color means their sporangia like structure is membranous and brown in color, and in each sorus sporangia are present in different stage. In each sorus sporangia are present in a different stage of the development without any definite sequence, means that all sporangia are different in a stage. You can see some sporangia are a big structure and some are the small, because of their development stage is not same. Some sporangia are develop in a stage, some are the young in a stage, and this type of development of sporangia is known as the lactosporangiate, because in this figure sporangia is not in a same age. Some sporangia are the young and some sporangia are mature, some are the fertile, some are the non-fertile, and this type of the development of sporangia is known as lactosporangiate. You can see this is the mixed type of the development sporangia, and this type is known as the lactosporangiate. Means addendum sporangia development is lactosporangiate type. Okay, this is the definition of sporophyll and false indusium. What is false indusium? And sporangia is the present dorsal surface of the leaf and both side of the present, but that lower side is a act as a false indusium. Act as a false indusium means their lower side is not fertile. Okay, then mature sporangia. The mature sporangia has 2 to 3 cell thick stalk, a spherical and elliptical head and head or capsule. You can see this is the mature sporangia. Mature sporangia is 2 to 3 cell thick stalk, 2 to 3 cell thick stalk, and a spherical and elliptical head or a capsule. You can see there are the stalk structure, they are 2 to 3 cell thick, and their upper portion is like a head and a capsule like structure. Okay, you can see this is the capsule, and their epidermal portion is known as the annulus. Okay, this is the dorsal surface, and there is the ventral surface of the sporangia. There are the this surface, and there are the lower surface, that is the upper surface, and there is the lower surface of the sporangia. Okay, you can see their both surface is the different type of. So this is the two figure, but there is the sporangia, one sporangia, there is the upper surface and that is the lower surface. Okay, and that upper portion is known as the capsule, and lower portion is known as the stalk, and lower portion is made up by 2 to 3 cell, and the mature sporangia 2 to 3 cell thick stalk, spherical, elliptical and or capsule. The capsule wall is only one cell thick. The capsule wall is only one cell thick, and the vertical row 10 to 20 cell in a capsule well develop a thick walled and present a distal annulus, and this arrangement 10 to 20 cell of the capsule well develop thick wall, and they are from the annulus. You can see in this figure there are the capsule cell, and capsule cell are attached with the annulus, and the capsule cell is made up by 10 to 20 cells, and the stomatium is present 2 to 6 walled cell. The stomatium is represented by 2 to 6 thin walled cell present at the distonet and annulus. You can see this is the stomatium. You can see this, there is the portion of the stomatium, and the stomatium portion is made up by 2 to 6 cell of the thin walled cell are present distal and annulus, and this arrangement of the cell is permit and easy splitting when the sporangium is dehiscence, and this type and many spore are present in the sporangia, and adiantum is the homosporous type. You can see in this figure, this is the sporangia, and there is the spring like structure is the annulus, and there is the help for the dehiscence of the spore, and the sporangia is the mature, their annular structure is open, and spore is the dehiscence. Okay, and the sporangia is made up by the first is the stalk 2 to 3 cell, and their capsule structure is made up by 10 to 20 cell, and they are attached with the annular structure, and their 2 to 6 cell thin cell are made thin cell are get together, and there is the structure is and made the structure is the stomatium, and stomatium is also connect with the annulus, and when the sporangia is the mature and the annulus is the spring like structure, and they are split to under portion, and this portion is bracted, and after there are the liberate the sporangia. Okay, you can see this is the structure of the sporangia, intine and exine, and also nucleus is present and cytoplasma is present. Okay, and in this adiantum the spore is not developed, but spore is developed into the gametangium. Okay, that is the sporangium, and most important questions, sporangia of adiantum. Okay, there are the most important figure of the sporangia. Draw this figure in mature sporangia. Okay, then gametophytic phase. In the previous lecture, morphology, anatomy and spore bearing organs, these all are included in the sporophytic phase. But after spore, that spore is developed into the gametes, and this phase is known as the gametophytic phase. Spore are pioneer stage of the gametophytic phase, means the spore is the first stage, primary stage of the gametophytic phase. The spore, this spore, you can see this spore are the tetrahedral, possess the triradiate reeds, means this is the structure, tetrahedral and triradiate reeds. Each spore is the haploid and uninucleated. Each spore is haploid and uninucleated. You can see this is the haploid and one nucleus is the present, mean it is a uninucleated, and spore develop onto the prothallus, and after spore is developed on the prothallus. You can see this is the prothallus structure, and this one spore is after develop onto the prothallus, and mature prothallus is the thin and green and flat chordate body. Okay, this spore is developed into the prothallus like structure. This is the prothallus, and now we discuss about the structure of prothallus, means the prothallus is the thin and green, the structure is the green in color and thin and flat structure and chordate in a shape. Their shape is the heart shape, and it is also known as the chordate, and it is only cell thick all over the except the region just posterior to apical notch. Okay, their cell structure is made up by one cell thick and their upper portion is the notch like structure is the present. Just posterior to the apical notch on the ventral side of the posterior on the ventral side of the posterior older portion develop a many unicellular rhizoid. You can see this is the many is the unicellular rhizoids are present, but which portion posterior older portion develop a many unicellular rhizoid means their posterior means behind the ventral surface of this prothallus there are develop a many unicellular rhizoids and cell prothallus are green because they are present a many chloroplast. Cell prothallus is the green in color because in this prothallus many chloroplast is the present. On the undersurface prothallus are present sex organs both Antheridia and Archegonia. On under the surface and this surface is present both Antheridia and Archegonia. You can see in this figure this upper portion, their upper portion is the Archegonia is present and their lower portion you can see there are the black dots like structure. These all are the Antheridia is present. Okay. And upper portion is known as the apical notch and some of the unicellular hair like structure that is the rhizoids and some of the hair like structure is the present and their upper notch portion in the Archegonia is present and their lower portion Antheridia is the present. Okay. In their prothallus Antheridia and Archegonia both sex organs they are developed in a prothallus structure. Okay. Then we first discussed Antheridia. Antheridia are present projecting on the posterior portion of the prothallus. Posterior means their lower portion. Okay. Antheridia is present project on the posterior portion of the prothallus means this is the prothallus structure their prothallus structure posterior portion means their lower portion Antheridia is the present and prothalli are the protandrous prothallus. This prothallus is the protandrous type of prothallus and what is the meaning of protandrous? Protandrous means Antheridia develop first and then Archegonia later means first develop Antheridia and then develop Archegonia and this type of prothallus development is known as the protandrous. This is the most important questions for a short questions must remember the addendum prothallus is the protandrous type and what is the protandrous type of prothallus. In protandrous type of prothallus Antheridia develop first and then develop Archegonia later. The mature Antheridium is the projected structure remains surrounded by the jacket consisting two ring cell and cover cell inside the jacket are present 2 to 80 uninucleated and multiflagellate and it is a anterior end of the anthrozoids and these are the 20 to 30 flagella are present at the end of the anterior of anthrozoids and the ring like and the ring cell absorb the water swell and shedding of the cover cell occur and anthrozoids thus find to come out. You can see this is the structure of androcytes and there are the uninucleated structure and remain the surrounded jacket consisting two layer and inside the jacket constituting 20 to 80 nucleated, uninucleated and multicellular flagella. It is the anterior of the anthrozoite, and 20 to 30 flagellates present, flagella are present anterior end of these anthrozoites. Okay, this is the structure of anthrozoites, and anthrozoites is developed the 20 to 30 anthrozoites. Anthridia are developed 20 to 30 anthrozoites, and their outer portion is known as the jacket layer, and their mature this anthridium, their cover cell is break, and some of these anthrozoites is liberate from this structure, and these anthrozoites and these androcytes is developed in the lower portion of the prothallus. You can see this is the black dot like structure is anthridia. You can see this is the anthridia, and their large structure is this. You can see this is the large structure of these androcytes, and also known as the anthridia. And after they are developed, they are being a meiosis, and after they are developed a 20 to 80 anthrozoites. Okay, and each anthrozoites have a 20 to 30 flagella. You can see 20 to 80 uninucleated, and there are the 20 to 30 flagella present in the anterior of the anthrozoites. Okay, and the ring cell is absorb and swell. This is the ring cell. This is the ring cell. And after a development of anthrozoites in inner part, the ring cell is break, swell. Ring cell is absorb of water, and their swell, and their cover cell is the bragged, and their cover cell bragged, some of the anthrozoites are liberate from this prothallus water structure. Okay, this is the development of anthrozoites. Then archegonia, you can see in this prothallus structure, this is upper portion is the archegonia, and there are the lower portion is developed the anthrozoites, and it is known as the anthridia. Archegonia is the lie near the apical notch of the thick and central apical cozon. The mature archegonium is differentiated into the 5 to 6 cells, high neck composed 4 vertical cells of cell row of the cells, and the ventral and neck cell is occupied by the neck canal cell and ventral canal cell, and ventral contain a single egg cell, and the cell project above the surface of the prothallus, and whereas the ventral remain embedded in it. You can see this is the structure of the archegonium. And first, how to develop? First, anthridial initial, and the anthridial initial is further divided into the 2 cell, and first is the primary cover cell, then central cell and lower cell, and their basal cell is further developed into the many cells. And you can see this is the mature structure of the archegonium, and their mature structure is made up by the upper portion is the neck cell, and then neck canal cell, and then ventral canal cell, and ventral canal cell have a single egg cell. And after a fertilization, this is the neck cell is the bragged. You can see this is the neck cell is bragged, and mucilaginous substance is secreted, and this mucilaginous substance is attached to the anthrozoites, and their anthrozoites is enter into this egg cell and fertilization. Okay, fertilization is the essential for the water is the essential for the fertilization. Now the water is the essential for the fertilization because of this is the chemotactic stimulation, means the anthrozoites are attached the enter of the archegonium. Chemotactic means this fertilization is made by a water, and water is the one type of the chemical substance. So it is known as the chemotactic stimulus. And the enterozoids are attached the archegonium, and many enterozoids get swells and entangled in gelatinous mass, but ultimately one of them enter into the egg and fuses with the egg nucleus, and diploid zygote is formed. Okay, many enterozoids are enter into this gelatinous mass, but only one cell is fused with this egg nucleus, and they are convert into the diploid zygote. Okay, this is the fertilization, and after fertilization they are further developed into the plant body structure, and this is known as the young sporophyte. And young zygote is starting point of the next diploid generation. Now the zygotes, it divide from the embryo, and embryo is differentiated into the leaves, primary root and secondary root. You can see this is the zygote structure, and the zygote is further developed into the new whole plant body structure. You can see this is the first leaf is further developed, and then prothallus is give the nutrition of this new thallus, and the embryonic root is developed into the primary root and secondary root. Okay, this is the sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction is depend on the sporophytic phase, because of after sporophytic phase this spore is developed into the prothallus. You can see this is the sporophytic phase, phase in prothallus and false induction and mature sporangia. And after mature sporangia is developed into the spore, and one spore is developed into the prothallus like structure, and prothallus is developed upper portion antheridia develop and lower portion archegonia develop, and archegonia develop in the upper portion and antheridia develop into the lower portion, and antheridia develop enterozoids, and archegonia develop this egg cell, and both are fused to together, and they are further develop into the zygote, and zygote is further develop into the whole plant body structure. Okay, this is the reproduction of antheridium. Okay, must see this video. Thank you so much.